My dear friends, can we please stand as we begin? Friends, blessed be God. He is the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, and He is a gentle Father. He is a God of all consolation. It is He who comforts all of us in our sorrow, so that we may offer others in their sorrow the consolation we've received from God ourselves. Our brother Ricardo, like all of us, was baptized with Christ in waters of baptism. It is our prayer and our hope that he will now share the vision and the glory of Christ's resurrection. I am sure we could manage a verse of or two of Amazing Grace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I be. My friends, when I die at my funeral service, I'll have this song as part of the program. And if you all sing it like that, I could trust you I'll be the first dead man that will get up and tap all you and I'll dead back. So we're going to change it. The same words, I'm going to give you a different melody for it. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it overflow. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it overflow. Fill my cup and let it overflow, let it overflow. So that was rehearsal. So now we're going to sing properly and you are going to clap. All right? One. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now wise. 'Twas grace. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it over. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it overflow. Fill my cup and let it overflow, let it overflow with. When you've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, with no less days to sing God's praise than when we first began. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it overflow. Fill my cup and let it overflow, let it overflow with. So fill it up, fill my cup and let it overflow. So fill it up, Fill my cup and let it overflow. Fill my cup and let it overflow. Let it overflow. That was much better, eh? Fill my cup and let it overflow. So fill it up. Fill my cup and let it overflow. Fill my cup and let it overflow. Let it overflow with love. My dear friends, can we please sit as we listen to the eulogy? Is there a eulogy? And I'm just asking, is there a eulogy? Is there somebody?
Good morning, everyone. At this point, I just want to say that everybody in here know the happy soul Carter was. He was a very happy soul. I was laughing, I was smiling. He would find the light in every single situation. And we all miss him, all right? We all miss him. He would be dearly missed. At this point, I don't know what to say. I'm not even going to lie. I don't know what to say. I just missing him. All right? It's hard to wake up sunsets and sunrise so hard without him, knowing that I'm going another day without getting a call, without seeing him, without hugging him. Right? He left two loving children that can't see after today. They can't see his face anymore. They can't feel his loving spirit. This was an untimely death. I know everyone say God have a plan, but this was an untimely death. It really and truly wasn't Cardo time to go. And just thinking that, just thinking about it, does make me so weak that I just have to fast forward that thought, right? But today I just wanted to let everybody in here know the loving soul Carter was, and I just wanted to say a few words on his behalf. Right, and he would want, I know for sure, he would want everybody in here to be strong, right? He would want all of us to live with his memory, right? The good memories he brought to each and every person here, right? So that's it for today.
Good day, everyone. For anybody who don't know me, I am Cardo's little sister. Cardo. First of all, he never called me by my name, which is Yannick. It was always Duba or little sis. I remember when Cardo got his first paycheck, he was probably 17 or 16. Probably even younger. He crossed from over by Mora Road. It have a big ravine at the cross, and I am sure up to this day, Frankie, our father, didn't even know he crossed. And every time he get paid, the first thing he used to come and do was come to get me, and we will go, and we will walk, and we'll buy cheese pie. And that was our thing every time he get paid. Cardo was very contented with life. It was one thing. He could have had $5 or $500. He was contented. No matter how I asked Cardo, how are you going? He was always good. He never once had a complaint. I'm just this bittersweet moment. He will be dearly missed. But it's good to see him go, meet his maker, and have some peace in life. And I know he would have loved me to tell you exactly how strong you are. You really are. And every time, I'll bring any. We had a meeting on August, and obviously it can't come true anymore. But God knows best. And I know he would want us, as you said, all to be very happy. So we just need to be strong and let the Lord open his arms and invite him in.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Before I speak, my mom would like to say something. Mommy?
Good afternoon, everybody. Yeah, bear with me a little bit because it's very hard on me right now, but I could tell you, everybody who knew Edison was a child that, you know, he have his little ups and downs, he have his ways, whatever, but he was a child. I knew him. He would say, "Mommy, what's it seen? Mommy, are you all right?" I say, "Yes, sweetheart, I'm all right." "Okay, I'm just checking up on you." Edison was America baby, born Christmas Day, 25th of December, 1990. He was a beautiful baby. He's so beautiful. But one day when he was around five or six months, He couldn't eat, he couldn't sleep, and I want to know what's wrong with him. He was looking pale. I took him down to Sour Crazy, to a Indian pundit, and he told me to bring him back 5 o'clock in the morning, and I did that. I took him 5 o'clock in the morning. As soon as I took him, he just grabbed him, took him in the back, did what he had to do, bring him back for me, and told me to take him home and let him rest. And I took him home, let him rest, because he was a beautiful child, beautiful. And in about 2-3 days, he was all right. He got a little maljo. He was a very handsome child, very, very, very handsome. Ricardo and my next son, Jonathan, is the tallest child I ever had. Ricardo is my sixth child. I have 7 boys, 3 girls. Ricardo is, I can't even say it. I shouldn't be burying my son today. My children should be burying me, not my burying my son. We are wrong. Ricardo always had a bright smile, broad smile. Everybody knew Carlo always smiled, always smiling. I was going to have this whole life in front of him. Oh my God. Oh. 31 years old. time behind his son looked just like Edison. Oh my God, his son just like Edison. But God know best. I say God know best. Oh God, my Lord, my child. Oh my God. Oh, I want to thank everyone for coming out. All who are watching.
Morning again, everyone. It hurts. It hurts a lot. I mean, like, when it happened, I cried, didn't sleep, wasn't eating properly. Me, like, my brother means so much to me. I wasn't expecting, you know, this to happen. You know, we never know when we're going to die, but I was going to meet my brother the same week, and it hurt so much because of the fact that we was going to, you know, like, have a little line, because I don't live in the area no more, you know. And, you know, my brother does call, check up, you know, and knowing that he's not here now, it hurts really bad. My brother is not a bad person to say, like, he does things to people for spite. I mean, like, he has his ways and stuff. No one is perfect, but my brother will want everyone to be okay, knowing that he is in a better place, and he knows that everyone is hurting now, but everything will be okay. And nothing much that could be said again. I mean, like, it hurts real bad. It hurts real bad. I really wish that he could be here now, like, having you just, like, think about, like, if he can just, wherever he is, you could, like, pull him out and talk to him one last time. I really wish that I could have done that, but God is good. Thank you.
Pleasant good morning, everyone. It's a welcome to be here this morning. On behalf of my wife and myself, this young man who's sitting lying on here, in fact, is my nephew. The young lady who was sampling just now, my niece. The young lady who was speaking on the phone just now is my sister. But however, may God rest his soul, he in a better place. No one was expecting this to happen today. It's sorry to be in this position at this point of time, but God knows everything. Right? But yes, we will miss him. Sorry, this is the bad time we are here together to celebrate the dead. But what we have to study at this point at this time now is the living, where our soul and our life will be now. Yes, tears will come, mourning, whatever the case may be. But this is the time for us to come together as family, as friends, as loved ones. We have to put aside every hate and pulling and tugging. This is not the time for this now. This is the time for us to come together as a family, share love. And I know many of us hurting inside, but be God, be your glory. But the Bible says, joy come in the morning. We crying all now, but joy will always be there for us. Right? And if we look at John 14, verse 15 to 18, as the Bible says, he will pray to his Father and send us a comforter. We are the comforter today for him and the family together. Because none of us know where we will be the moment or the opportunity. So we have to say, thank God we are alive today. We have to try our best to live good. Yes, I know what I said before. Hurt and everything will come behind. But at the end of the day, we have to live life as one day at a time. As Jesus said, live for today. Because no one knows about tomorrow. We know about now. Because if you come now and you say, hey, let me go, are you ready to go? No one is ready. So we have to live our life peaceful, loving, with comfort. Many people say they know God, but having a relationship with God, then you will know if my life is right or just fooling myself. So I want to say on behalf of, as I said before, my wife and my family, it's a sad day. It's a sad moment. But this is not the time for us to be hating and pulling and talking behind one another. We have to show love. We have to be together. Because when I heard the news that Sunday night, I felt sad, but life goes on. Let God be the judge. We cannot judge no one. We have to judge ourselves. We have to judge ourselves, because if that cloud bursts, no one is ready. So as I said before, it's sad, but we have to move on. We have to move on. So thank you very much. You all have a blessed day.
Hi, good morning again. Mother Michelle want to like to say a few words. Hello.
What is that?
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. He's going to speak now. He's going to speak now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Madam Michelle, I want to like to say a few words. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, you can talk now.
Okay, I'm hearing you. Good morning, everyone. We give God praise and thanks this morning for life's spirit and his tender mercies and his loving kindness. To the Douglas family, I extend my deepest sympathy out of my heart from the blood of Jesus Christ. I just want to leave some comforting words with you this morning. In the scripture said, man that is born of a woman is of but a short time to live and is full of trouble. Isaiah declared that all flesh is grass. In the morning, we are fresh and green, and in the evening, we are withered away in God. What is man that thou art so mindful of? And the son of man that thou visited. John 14:1 says, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. So in my Father's house, there are many mansions. And if it was not so, I would have told you. But I've gone to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also. So I pray Almighty God this morning that Richard would be with the arms of Jesus. So when that resurrection comes, the angels will take him from the grave to glory. I pray God this morning that the family will grieve together. They will mourn together. They will rejoice together. But they can only do it in the arms of Jesus. Put all your trust in the Lord this morning. And let him comfort you all at this time of grief. Comfort you all that when the time comes, that you can say with a bold assurance, I know my Redeemer liveth because he lives in me. This morning, to the bereaved family, it's a sad case of an sad occasion, and it's an untimely death. But the Bible says that the devil come to steal, kill, and destroy. And the son life was destroyed by the devil. But he used mankind to destroy him. But at the end of the day, judgment will come to every man. And he will pay every man according to his work shall be. Whether it be good or whether it will be bad. Revelation 22 tells us, he will pay every man. This morning, I want to leave with you. When Cain killed Abel, the Lord put a mark on Cain and put a mark in him that anywhere that Cain go, he would see that mark so they would not kill him. I pray Almighty God that the soul that was taken by the hands of a man, he will come to judgment before God. Man may not judge him, but God will judge him. And I pray God that he would repent and come to Christ so that his soul will be saved. To the Douglas family, hold on. The battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Hold on, hold on, hold on. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen.
Good morning, each and everyone. I'm Carlo's mother-in-law. That's my daughter there. Carlo's girlfriend. His daughter, mother. Those two young ladies at the back there are my children. I'm a mother of six. One son and five daughters. I can die the biggest in the set because she's the youngest daughter, but she's the biggest. The one at the end there in the black and red, she's the first daughter. And so they go on. I can feel the pain of Miss Brenda this morning because I'm a mother too. She cannot see her son go down in the grave, which she wasn't expecting to see at this time. All parents really look at, they don't look forward to burying their children. They look forward to their children burying them. But unfortunately it happened that Carlo's life was cut off from him at the age of 31. It's so sad to know that he leave his little daughter. He wouldn't see her take her first day in school, nor his son. He wouldn't see him go to school, finish his schooling. But this morning, on behalf of my family, I want to say how sorry I am about this situation, how I felt it, because God was to me like a son. He sleep on my bed, he eat whatever I cook when he come by me. Mother-in-law make fry bake, that was his motto, he fry bake. He like fry bake, right? And every time he come by me, he want fry bake. And he was like a son to me. He was never, we had little differences, but when we come together, we end up as a family, and each and every one of us as one. He and my son is another funeral kind of person. He went to work today. But when he get the news, he gets so upset. He walk inside and he cuff the wardrobe and break up the back of my wardrobe right now. Right? Because he and Carlo, they play games together, they lie down on the bed together, they laugh, they talk and everything together. He's like a big brother to him. And right now I will say to God be the glory. The Lord gave and the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know it's hard on Akenda, but the Lord will see her through. He will give her the strength to go through it. It's hard on the trip, Ari, because every morning and every evening she asks for her daddy. And he'll give them the strength to go through it. And give me the strength. I ask him most of all for the strength to give me the strength to stand up, to prop Kenda by and every bend inside. I will top it off by singing a little song for you all. Life on earth is moving fast and it quickly passes by. From the moment of your birth until the time has come to die. But God has given us a choice to decide our destiny. In a million years, where will you be? Where will you be in a million years from now? Will you be happy? Will you be singing when ages roll and time eternity? That's why I ask this question. Where will you be? Where will you be in a million years from now? Will you be happy? Will you be singing when ages roll and time eternity? That's why I ask this question. Where will you be? That's why I ask this question. Where will we be?
Please stand and let us pray. O God, in whom sinners find mercy and saints find joy, we pray to you today for our brother Ricardo, whose body we will honor with Christian burial, that he may be delivered from the bounds of death. Admit him now to the joyful company of your saints, and raise him up on the last day to rejoice in your presence forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity with the Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please sit. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather was raised, who is at the right hand of God and intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No. In all these things, we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced of this, that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will ever be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. As a response, please repeat after me, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Together. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Response, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort. Response, the Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Response, the Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Response, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Please stand for a proclamation of the gospel. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. And I'll read to you from John 14, verses 1 through to 6. And I'll use the Jerusalem Bible translation. Jesus said to his disciples, "Not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. For there are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare you a place. And after I have gone to prepare you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be there too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. So how can we know the way?" "I am the way, the truth, and the life," Jesus said to him. No one can come to the Father except through me. My friends, this is good news. It is a gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please sit for a few minutes. Sit for a few minutes. My friends, this morning, you and I, we come together to memorialize Kadu. We come together to give thanks to God for his life. We come together with his common law wife, his children, his mother, uncles, sisters, mother-in-law. We come together to celebrate him. Yes, there are many questions. Yes, there will be more questions than answers. We all will feel like our world is closing. And I sympathize with Kadu's mother, or Kadu's parents. And yes, most mothers and fathers, it is their dream that my children will bury me. But today, it is not that. Today, it is a mother, even in her absence, having to say goodbye to her son, having to see her son being buried. And that must be hard for her, for a parent, mother or father. It's also hard for siblings as well. But my friends, in all of this, the question we have to ask is, where will we get the strength, the courage, and the hope to continue? The prophet Jeremiah, in his Lamentations, from the book of Lamentation, chapter 3, when Jeremiah said, "All hope has gone," Jeremiah suddenly realized that even if I feel the way that I do feel, I will renew my trust in God, because God is faithful, and every morning he renews his promises to us. The question, friends, is, do you believe that? Do you believe that with the passing of Kadu, that all hope is gone? Or do you believe that God is faithful, and as the prophet Jeremiah says, every morning his faithfulness is renewed? And that's why I like the old Anglican song which says, "Great is thy faithfulness, O God my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not. Thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever, ever wilt be." My friends, the question is, do you believe this? Do you believe that even at this moment, God is faithful to you, Kado's family and friends? That morning by morning, his favors are renewed. But friends, there is something else that I want to say to you. Kado's wife, girlfriend, said, "This is an untimely death," she said. Kado's sister almost could not come to terms with him not being here. My friends, no death is untimely. None of them. We might not have been prepared for it. That's a difference. But it's not untimely. And therefore, the question is, as we celebrate and memorialize Kado, what's about you? Are you prepared for your death? My friends, some of us, we will be leaving this chapel and we might not get home. You might just leave this chapel and crossing the road and a car knock you. You'll say it's an untimely death. No, that's the way you had to go. But the question is, are you prepared for it? Are you prepared for life, for death? And the way we prepare ourselves for our death is by living life well. Living life well means that we have to do what God asks of us. Kado's uncle said, we have to, maybe I'm paraphrasing him now, we have to get to know God. And I say these days that all Christians, no apologies at all Christians get me vexed. Whatever religion you belong to, even I myself get myself vexed at times. Because too very often we talk the talk, we don't walk the walk. Too very often we talk God, but we don't put God in our lives. Too very often we Christians, we are the stumbling blocks preventing others from getting to God. Because when people that want to come to church, that want to come to God, they see the way we live our lives, they say, if that is what it is to be Christian, boy, I don't want to be Christian. I'll go stay out there. We Christians, we at times are stumbling blocks. By the way we treat others, people will come to God, or they will, because you know, friends, you cannot see God, you know. You cannot see physical God. What we are supposed to see, or who we are supposed to see, we are supposed to see the face of God in every person around us. And because the faces that people at times see is not the face of God, we who are Christians, we don't reflect God. We are poor representations of what God is like. You know, there is something that I try to wrap my head around, that you would have some people, and I'm not judging anybody, they're in church every day, boy. Sunday to Sunday, they're in church. But they can't say good morning to the neighbor next door. That does not make sense. Don't go to church if that is your attitude. Church don't make nothing to you, you know. You in church Sunday to Sunday, and you just come from church and you cursing the neighbor left, right, and center. Is that what church is about? Is that what Christianity is about? But my friends, when I come from church, when I go to church and I come from church and I see the neighbor that hate me, the neighbor that don't want to talk to me, the neighbor that's cursing me, I will say to the neighbor, Nibs, good morning. How are you going, Nibs? Because of what I got from church, I could come and tell the neighbor. Because I just got Jesus from church and I want the neighbor to get Jesus as well so that the neighbor could change his ways. Or her ways. That's what it is to be Christian. We are called Christians because we are supposed to be Christ-like. Let me challenge you who are sitting in the chapel now and those who are listening via live stream. You all knew Kadu. You all knew him. How many of you reflected to Kadu the face of God? How many of you, when Kadu was wherever doing, I don't know Kadu, how many of you had the courage to say, Kadu, come! Come, Dogode. How many of you? How many of you worked with him and said, this is not what life is about? How many of you reflected to him the face of God and the face of Jesus? That, brother, I'm happy that you did it. Because that is what Christianity is about. That is what Christianity is about. Christianity is about bringing people to God. I remember some years ago, one of our politicians said, let's go down the road together. I said, no, sir, I ain't going down. I'm going up. Me ain't going down with you. Because my thing is, if somebody is going the wrong way, I'll pull the person up. But brother, sister, you're not taking me down with you. You're going down alone. I'll pull you up. So my friends, today, the challenge is yours. Cry, yes. Memorialize, yes. Put God in your life, yes. And ask yourself, the times when I could help Kadu and I probably did not help him, God forgive me. And I will not do it to another person to go down the same road. That is what Christianity is about. That is what being like Christ is. Showing each other the face of Christ. So we pray this morning for Kadu's family. We pray for his mother in particular. We pray for his wife. We pray for his children. That would probably always have the question, where is daddy? And mommy, when they ask you, where is daddy? Say to them, daddy is not far from you. Daddy is just in the next room, but you cannot see him. But as you grow older, I will show you daddy. And you show Kadu's children's daddy by the memories you have of him. Tell them the kind of person their father was. And Kado will never be far from them. We thank God for him. We thank God for life. Amen. Please stand and let us pray. All right, just sit, let the person talk, and we'll continue.
Morning, everyone. Here's brother. One want to say some words. Go ahead and run.
Hello, good evening, brother. My name is Ryan. I'm Carlos' little brother.
Yeah.
That hit me extremely hard because Carlos is not only an older brother but a mentor and a teacher to me as well. We grew up together from small till adults. He always had my back to anything. He always deeply motivated me no matter what I did. To see him just come and leave so early in my life, I wasn't ready for it, and I'm still not ready for it. All the memories I had with us in San Juan growing up, he was a person who introduced me to all the stuff I enjoy, games, animals, beaches, everything like that. I remember some few days Ricardo got chicken pox. And as his little brother, I was laughing at him, making fun of him. And he obviously said, watch my laugh too. But that day, he decided that I entertained with him too much. So he ran me down, and I ended up running out of the gate into the road. He caught me with a big hug and lift me off of the ground and walk me straight back home. And in 2 days' time, I also got chicken pox, so I could not laugh at him again and make any kind of joke. And these are the memories I had with my brother that I really can't reminisce with him again and laugh about it again because it's something only I alone know now. And in our household, he always used to talk about he always wanted to do better for me and my little sister Yannick as well, because he always had us in his thoughts, always thinking about us, our well-being. He was so proud of my little sister with everything she's doing. He always used to talk to me about it and proud of me as well, how I'm trying to better myself as well. This whole scenario, it really destroyed my happiness at that moment. I have no sort of happiness at the moment without my brother. The amount of trouble we used to get in together, all these different things, hide from our father. And at Christmas, 2 months like in the October, our father bought a PlayStation 1 for Kado around the time it now came out. But somehow Kado found out our father was hiding it under the bed. So he said, Bones, he never used to call me Ryan, as always Bones. That's my nickname. Bones, let me go and play a game. So he would go and take out the game out of the box, look on to make sure our father gone to work already. And we would play a game, he would teach me. We will enjoy it, and always time my father before he come back to pack it back in the box and put it under the bed so he wouldn't notice. This went on for 2 months until his birthday, and my father didn't know a thing. All these memories. It also had a time my father used to tell us, don't go nowhere, stay home, and behave ourselves. But again, Cardo was my big brother, teaching me again. He took me to a river in San Juan called the Blue Sea, me and his friend Devon Guerra. During the whole process, I was enjoying myself in the water. Cardo and Devon saw a farmer had some bulls in his yard and going interfering with some of the bulls, he and Devon. And one of the bulls ran him down into the water. So Cardo jumped in the water and climbed up the rock, trying to get away from the bulls. And I was there just laughing the whole time away. I could go on and on all day about different kind of memories we had, but it really is hurting me to know that I'm the only person to remember all these things that I went. And I thank everyone for being there. I am so sorry I couldn't be there this day to say my final farewells to him. And my heart is in pieces right now. Thank everyone again for coming out. Have a good day. Bye.
Okay. Thank you.
My dear friends, before we go our separate ways, may we take leave of our brother Ricardo. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our faith, our hope. For one day we will greet Cardo again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. It is into your hands, Father of mercies, that we commend the soul of our brother Ricardo in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died with Christ, he will be raised up again on the last day. Lord, we give thanks for the blessings which you've bestowed upon him in this life. These, Lord, are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Ricardo and help us remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until, Lord, we all will meet with you and with our brother Ricardo forever. We gather to commend the soul of Ricardo, our brother, to God our Father, and to commit his body to the earth, that it might return to dust the element from which it was drawn. But it is in the spirit of faith, in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from death, that we raise our voices in song and in prayer. And because God has chosen to call Ricardo from this life to himself, we commit his body to you. For my friends, remember always that you and I, we are dust, we are ashes. It is from dust and ashes we come. It is to dust and ashes shall we go one day to choose. Earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his own in glory. He is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Ricardo to God, our Father, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise his body up on the last day. And may your light be upon him forever. Lord, receive his soul. Present him to God. Present his soul to God Most High. My friends, please stand, bow your heads, and pray with me. And as we turn our thoughts, our minds to God, I ask you to bring to your prayer Ricardo's mother, his parents, his wife and children, his siblings, and all those for whom today, saying farewell to Kado, is a hard and difficult time. Bring them before God. And so, my friends, I also say to you that if for one reason or another Ricardo might or may have offended you, please forgive him. Let him go. Let him go. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. Lord, you are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear us, your children, as we cry out to you in our need. Strengthen our faith in your goodness, in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Ricardo, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Jesus taught us how to call God Father. It is with confidence and with courage we turn to our Father and pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You wanted to say something? You wanted to say something?
Good day, good day, everybody. Yeah, Ice Cardo, brother. He big brother. Can't believe right now, I don't know if we're all feeling like me in a dream world, like Cardo, alive still. One thing I could say, for me as a big brother, Cardo, needs to talk to me like my big brother. You understand? When I go on off my rockers or I go on in a element, this fella here needs to calm me back down. Talk to me different. Make me calm myself. Cardo needs to do that. At the age he was, I used to be shocked and all he level. Now, even though as I said that, because all of we need each other, because I need to talk to my brother too. I used to always tell my brother good things, good. How to live good. Never want him in no kind of trouble, never want to see him get in trouble, or to even see him like this here now. This is the most dreadful thing in my life. I ever had the stomach. Like days are just in the matrix, like I don't know if I'm up or sleeping, to tell you the truth. And I just want some of you to know now in all your life, this is the matrix. And you see the thoughts and the energy we carrying with we daily is what affecting us in life. And people need to change their mindset and start thinking good, because everything you harm and damage out here, it comes back to you. People need to live all your life good in this matrix. When you bounce your toe or your foot, is you just feel it. You understand? I don't know much I could say here right now, because all I could talk to is the living. My brother done gone. He done gone to a place where he had a deliver whoever. But this time here now, for everybody who in here who know Cardo, I feel the best thing Cardo wanna see everybody do is live their life to the fullest and the best. And I the most I could do for my brother right now. Try to get myself on top, I could even help his daughter, his child mother, do some kind of thing. Because We spread it, be feeling down and getting oppressed, as this man say. People going to church, they name talking to the neighbor, they never thinking, they playing the demons are being real. And we in a construct of our dream world. Why all are we just be dreaming for thing and wishing for thing? It's because everybody are dreaming and make this world. We in a luck. And if we don't change we mindset in the dream, we will never get out of this problem. Just what I tell you. Plenty of you watch Matrix and then understand it. I know I tell you now. I end up in an accident and I wake up. I see a bright light with energy. Everything is energy moving. Energy, mind, into matter. You understand? So this year happened for a reason for all of you to come together. And what matter is that we need to wake up and shape back with life into goodness. Why a few is make sure and for? Because when we go, them children them gonna live the life after what we set for them. The dream will we leave for them. So if we don't construct this dream well into the right way, we will just be leaving destruction for them. And sickness and everything we're here now. Because all this is a construct. What you think about in your mind, you could have it after in this plane. How people dream about plane and airplane until we have one now. How people dream about car, house, this, that, all the fancy things are wrong with. And all these things are dead things. It have a name. When you're born with your mother, you're born without everything. You're born naked. And it's naked, you're going back. It's just a spirit, just an avatar body. People not doing good in the body. I being real, that is why I know. Because when I sit down with Cardo, we used to smoke, lime, and drink, and talk sensible thing. And look, she right there. She know I used to command fives. She, that girl know, she used to be quiet there. The quietest woman, the woman who going and walk, I know that girl. You understand? I could never say she treat my brother bad, but she's never warned him. You understand? We man just go out there and do all kind of thing. I was wild like a fire, I telling you. Until they had a change. Because life just get real. Everybody laugh, I telling you, when I crash in my car, I see what going on with me, I come out my body. I see that. I wasn't frightened. It's our energy. Don't be frightened or nothing, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to talk and pretend. People just pretend too much. That's why it has so much a fake. That's why long time you just want to get a girl, you just want to see a party, you don't even want to date. Because you don't want to find out people, people doesn't want to find out the truth. They just want the communication, they just want to lie to one another. And that will be living today, a lie people. I tell you, it's a lie. We living in illusions. We living in a bubble. And you do what I fear children, people. Wake up out of the matrix. Live good and treat people good because it's the same thing for you.
And there is a calypso I want you all to remember. Remember we jib to it? The totin feelings. Remember that calypso? The totin feelings. Too many of us are totin feelings. So please let go of the feelings. Let go and let God. Please stand. My friends, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord let his face shine upon you and may he be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and may he give you peace. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we'll end with two verses of When We All Get to Heaven. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercies and his grace. In that mansion, bright and blessed, he's prepared for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathways, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. Oh, when we all get to heaven, What a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory when we all get to heaven. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We will sing and shout the victory. My friends, please change our lives. And if we change our lives, we will be honoring Ricardo by our lives. Good afternoon, everybody.
times separation brings. You never let me know it, you never let it show, because you loved me. And obviously there's so much more left to say. If you were with me today, face to face.